It's easy to create an extruded 3D logo using Avid FX in conjunction with Avid Media Composer. The steps in this tutorial will also work if you are running Boris Red. To start, edit a graphic that contains an alpha channel into an Avid sequence. Then, navigate to the Project window and click on the Purple Effects tab. Look for the Title Matte effect located within the Avid FX category. Drag the Title Matte effect onto the clip you've placed on V2. Then, make sure the track indicator is turned on, and press the Effect Mode button. The Effect Editor window will appear. Click on the Launch User Interface button. This will launch Avid FX. Navigate to the Window menu, and choose Show Vector Trace Palette. This will bring forward the Options tab window. Click on the Vector Trace tab, and set the Trace channel to Alpha. Then go ahead and close the Options tab. Now, click on the Preview Track button for the Video 1 logo track. If you did not see the Avid FX toolbar, press Command 6 to bring it forward. Then, select the Vector Trace button from the toolbar. Hold down the Option plus Shift keys and draw a lasso around your logo. When you let go of the mouse button, a spline track will be created, and the logo should now be traced with a red line around it. Now close the tab for the preview window. Navigate back to the timeline window and change the spline track from 3D line art to 3D extrusion. This will create a 3D object from your logo. Navigate to the Controls tab window and adjust the Y spin parameter so the logo is partially on its edge. Then click on the Extrusion tab to adjust the amount of extrusion. Next, click on the Textures tab. Click the checkbox to activate the front texture. The front texture should fill itself from the original graphic that's on V1. For an added effect, navigate to the Filters menu and choose Lights, Raise, Puffy. Change the Apply mode for the rays from In Front to Behind. Then go ahead and increase the ray length. And finally, you won't need the original graphic that's on V1 anymore. You can go ahead and delete it. When you're done, press the Apply button in the lower right corner of the timeline window. This will take you back to Avid Media Composer. Click the Render button to render the effect. Okay, that's it. Check it out. For other great tips like this, or to enroll in a certified Avid Media Composer training course, visit geniusdv.com.